Welcome to episode 4 of Borderland Build Series. We are here this morning at Opposite Lock, Breakfast Creek, the house of brands, where we're getting stacks fitted to the DMAX over the next few days. We are getting Opposite Lock bar work done, Redback Exhaust, what have I forgotten?
Safari Armax snorkels going on as well. We're getting Direction Plus catch can and Direction Plus diesel pre-filter. What else? Diff breathers. This thing's getting the works all under the one roof, which is awesome. So when we drive it out of here, it's going to be pretty much looking almost finished.
Yeah.
Just got a brake upgrade to go after this, wheels and tyres, and then the all-important 12-volt as well. So can't wait to get in the workshop, but let's go meet the team. Mr. Nick Ball, thank you very much for having us. Thank you for fitting out the DMAX for us with the team. We're super excited to get, well, we're getting the works done on the DMAX here today. So, starting off with the bar, perhaps.
Yeah, so I'm guessing you've done a fair bit of research and that's why you came to us.
We have.
And there's common things that you might see on our bars on the outside that might make you go, yeah, well, let's have a look at Opposite Lock. And so some of those are looking at your aerial tabs. Obviously, we've got three and we've had three in our bars for a very long time.
Yep. That way people can have a phone extending aerial, they can have a UHF aerial and a sand flag all in the bar at the same time. We have a 60 mil tube. We were the first bull bar manufacturer to do that many years ago. We tried to run the 60 mil tube originally, one, because it looked aesthetically a lot better on a modern car when we first started to do it. But also we found that it gave us a bit more strength on the cars that we did need it on. So whenever you come with a, you know, hit a solid object or a big kangaroo, you know, you've got the peace of mind to know that that's not going anywhere. You'll see in the back of our bull bars, we actually have the tube come right through and then weld down into the corner here. And that way, if you cop a hit on the side, on the wing only,
it's not going to completely fold in on you.
Yeah, correct. Yeah.
Well, it's an awesome looking bar. We can't wait to put it on the DMAX.
Awesome.
Thanks.
Let's get into it.
Cheers. Let's do it.
So we've just unboxed our Redback exhaust, and I just wanted to show you the difference between this new one and the old factory one we've already pulled out. Obviously a massive difference in the build quality of these. So we're installing a 3-inch DPF back exhaust onto the DMAX now.
Righto, so the exhaust is on. We've gone with the Redback DPF back exhaust. So a few reasons. Looks, it looks good. Looks way better than the factory one that Em was showing you before. Performance, we're going to get some improved performance out of it, obviously, and sound as well. So we haven't started her up yet. And I think we're pretty much ready to do that. So we might bring it down off the hoist and kick it over, see how it sounds. All right, let's start her up.
Day two, the side steps are on. We are now up to the point where the bull bar is going on, which is super exciting. same time, we're also going to be installing our winch as well. When deciding whether or not to get a winch for your four-wheel drive, it really depends on what you're using it for. If you're not leaving the bitumen, you're really not going to need one. But if you love off-roading like we do, it's definitely an essential piece of equipment that you're going to need, whether it's getting you unstuck, moving objects off the road, or even helping someone else that might be in a bit of a sticky situation. You can install the winches on the front of the vehicle, which is what we're going to be doing. But you can also get one installed on the rear if that's something that you feel like you need as well. We have decided to go with the Rough Country 10,000 pound winch with the synthetic rope. It's not necessarily the biggest winch we could have gone with, but we're not towing. It's the Rough Country products are really well made. They're really tough. So we feel really confident that this is definitely going to do the job for us on our big lap. But it is really important to figure out which winch is ideal for your setup or your rig.
What the truck just brought in. Safari Armax will be going on shortly, so that'll be cool. Plenty of airflow. Big chunky boy.
So our snorkel is on. How good is it looking? Installing a snorkel was a really important part of the build for Maddie and I. And these types of cars, the air intake is typically down in the engine bay. As soon as you install a snorkel, it elevates it up so that you're drawing in cleaner, uncontaminated air as compared to some of the air that you might get closer to the engine that might be quite dusty. Drawing in cleaner air then improves your engine performance and efficiency as well. Obviously, if you like doing water crossings like we do, particularly the slightly deeper ones, and fingers crossed we get to do quite a few on the upcoming lap, it is really important to have snorkel as well. Having that air intake closer to the roofline of the car as compared to the engine is going to protect your engine. Obviously, water doesn't compress like air does, so even getting a little bit of water into your engine combustion chamber can cause quite serious issues. All the benefits that I just spoke about having a snorkel become pretty redundant if it's not sealed properly though. So it is really important to do the installation of a snorkel correctly, which is why we left it in the capable hands of the guys here at Opposite Lock. Maddie and I have decided to go with the Safari Armax snorkel for a couple of reasons. We, one, just really like how it looks. We think it looks really tough. We really like the aesthetic of it, and it fits the vision of what we had for the DMAX when we were planning it. But also it has Safari's water separation style air ram with a 4-inch inlet. Now the size of that is really going to optimize the airflow extremely well on our trip.
So we've ordered in some direction plus bits and pieces to go on the build. Throttle controller, so we're going to install that ourselves. That's really, really easy to put on. We're not going to get the guys to do it at the workshop because they've got plenty of other stuff going on. So we'll do another video on that a little bit later. We've got the oil separator, so the ProVent 200 catch can. So really important for protecting the engine against oil and soot contamination. Just have to remember to make sure you stay on top of the maintenance and make sure you actually empty it and keep an eye on it. And then it's going to do its job really, really well. We've also got a diesel pre-filter. So this sits before the factory filter and it filters out some of the bigger contaminants that can get into fuel and also water as well. So super important for us, particularly with the kind of traveling that we're doing, although you can get water and dirty fuel even in the city, but particularly if you're way out west somewhere and you're at a servo that doesn't have a particularly high fuel turnover, you can often find that you're going to get dirty stuff in. So this is going to help us to protect against water and some of those bigger contaminants as well before it even gets to the factory filter. So that's a first line of defense as far as fuel goes. Done here at Opposite Lock. A massive thank you to the team at the Breakfast Creek store here in Brizzy. These guys have been absolutely amazing. We're really, really happy with the attention to detail and care that's gone into the build with these guys. They've been extremely meticulous and honestly just done a great job all around. When you look at the car up close, you can see that there's some real workmanship that's happened here. So thank you guys. A massive thank you to Maddie at the store here, to Nick and to Job for all of the hard work fitting it out.
Thank you so much for tuning into this week's episode. We really appreciate it. It genuinely helps us so much if you could like and subscribe to the channel. It means we can keep making these videos. The countdown is on until our big lap starts. We can't wait to show you this thing out and about tackling the country. Next episode, we have a massive brake upgrade happening on the D-Max. Stay tuned to see exactly what we're getting done. Thanks again, guys. We'll see you in the next episode.
See you soon.